So like this we are writing programs. Okay, now instance variable with access specifier. Earlier this, now I have told you instance variable without access specifier. Now if you are putting with access specifier, what will be happen? So public class, class inst, inst variable, this is the instance variable. Again any child class, variable of any kind called public string name. So see, this is a public is access specifier. This public is access specifier. So instance variable with an access specifier, and then the string is the data type, that is composite data type, as I told just now, that string and array is composite data type, or you can say that non-primitive data type. In the name of the variable. Okay, so variable for employee class, here again one more variable, that is private, access specifier is private, and int is the data type and age is given. Then again a method is written, that method is also with access specifier, that is public, instance where string per name, name per name, so name per name, that is here, you know, per name, whatever data will come through this argument will go to name variable that is declared inside the class, that is instance variable. So see, we are calling this instance variable in method, and we are assigning a value with method into the instance variable. The instance variable is the name, and per name is the value which is coming through method. Per name is argument which is given in the method. Okay, so now public, again another method, public void set age. So here again we are getting int, same as above, age is instance variable that is declared just below the class age, and then per age is given in the method, that is set age method. And then public void, again one more method, that is print per. So here three methods are declared. First is instance where, first is instance where, second is set age, third is pay. So three methods are declared inside a class, and all these three methods are accessing instance variable. So this is how we are going to do. Now in this method, we are printing again printed. So in the first, system dot out print, the name of the person is printed. In the second, age is printed. So with three methods, third method is only for displaying. Now main method is written, public static void main string args, and object of the class is created, that is instance where per del, and then an argument is passed over here, Rahul. So here we are just creating an object of the class, and argument is given Rahul, and then through object of the class we have given the age, and then through object of the class we are just displaying the output. So like this, output will be the name of the person is Rahul and age. So like this we can do that. Just look at this code, how it is being displayed over here. This is more important. And then come to the next page. Static variable. So that is more important to know. Static variable or class variables are declared. Static variables or class variables are declared in a class and outside a method. See, just like a instance variable, it is declared inside the class but outside a method with a static keyword. The keyword will be used just before that variable. Static variables are created at the time of starting program execution and destroyed at the end of the program execution. So static, when you start the program it is working, and you stop the program it is not working. So syntax, just look at public class, class name, this is class declaration, and then public C, access specifier, that is public, and after that static is used. So static is the keyword. And data type, variable, and then the value. So public void object, this is the method, and then this is the structure. So that keep in mind how it can be created static. So let's look at the real life example. Class static variable salary. So here public static int age. And just below it, public static string name. So two variables are declared, and these two are with a static keyword. And then close public class person, and then in this method, main method, access variables without object. So see, whenever any variable which is declared with a static keyword, we are not supposed to create the object of the class. Again, I am speaking, please keep in mind, whenever we are using a static keyword in the variable, we are not supposed to create object of the class here in the main method. Whenever it is static, because static variable directly it will be accessed by your main method. So static var dot age. So directly you just direct call the class and then the name of the variable with dot operator. So here just look at static where is the name of class, and you are not creating object, directly you are assigning the data or value with age variable. So you are putting this dot operator between a static where dot and age. So this way you will get the age, and then we are going to print what name of the person. So here you can see that static var directly class name, not object name, directly class name, and then dot name, and then system dot out print line age of person, static var dot age, directly class name with variable, static variable. So please keep in mind the variable should be static, then only we can access directly in the main method. with the but we are supposed to give class name also, so that we can compile. Okay, compile, then you will get the output, name of the person Gautam and the age of person is 45. So like this, static variables can be declared, and the benefit of the static variable, we are not supposed to create object of the class directly. We can access it into the main method, and you can see this example. Now the scope and lifetime of the variables, scope and lifetime of variables. So what is the scope and what is the life of variables? So Java allows variables to be defined inside any block. Block means the curly braces. A block defines a scope. So block means a scope. Scope means a range. The scope determines what objects are visible to other parts of the program and the lifetime of the objects. So a scope determines what objects are visible to the other parts of the program and lifetime of the objects. In Java, the scope are those defined by a class. In Java, the scopes are those defined by a class and those defined by a method. So the scope will be decided or defined by class and defined by a method. Whatever the scope defined by a method begin with its curly braces and closing by curly braces. So variable defined inside a scope are not visible. So those variables which are defined inside a scope are not visible or accessible to the code that is defined outside the scope. So that means those variables which is defined inside the curly braces are not supposed to access by other variables which is defined inside the curly braces. So thus, when a variable is declared in a scope, it is being protected from unauthorized access from outside the scope. So that means your variable is safe if it is defined inside a scope. Variables are created when their scope is entered and destroyed when their scope is left. So life is that when a scope is entered and it is working, and when a scope is left, it is destroyed. The scope and lifetime of variables. Look at one program, public void main, int outer 100, known to all codes within main. This is main variable, and then another curly braces start, and here another variable is declared, that is inner 200. So outer inner are known here because it is inside, that's why outer will come in the inner, and then system.out.print outer is outer. See, outer is outer and inner is inner. So error inner not known here. So look at let me tell you. So this is inner. So whenever you are printing inner, so error inner not known here, because inner is declared known only to this block. This block system.out.print. So if you are going to print inner outside of this block, it will not be printed, but outer can be printed because outer is just in this block. So inner is this in this block here, it says started from here, and inner it will not be printed over here. And if you are printing, then no doubt this message will give error to you. So outer is still known here. Outer can be printed, but inner cannot be printed. So this is what lifetime and scope of the variable. Local variable and global variable. What is this local variable and global? As I told to you, In a multifunction program, many important data items are placed as a global so that they may be accessed by all functions, and that global variable we can say that instance variable. Other items are placed as a local data. So the variable which is declared inside the method is the local, and which can be used within the specific function, within a specific block. It can be represented as follows. So let's look at on this program. Class int b is the instance or global variable. Instance can be said as a global variable, and then method word disk 1. So int a, assignment operator 5, this is called local variable because it is inside the method, and then you are printing, then a can be printed, b can be printed because a is local and b is global. So that's why in this block you can see that in this block you can print a and b both because b is global and a is local. What is to? So here just look at system.outprint. Value of a is a, so a will not be printed because a is declared here and that is local, so that's why it will not be printed over here. It is wrong. Now system out print b is global, that it can be printed, no problem at all. This can be printed, but this cannot be printed. Close. So like this, local variable and global variable. We'll give a compile time error. As I told you, a scope of variable a exists within the disk 1 function. So here we are working with two functions within a class. Since b is a global variable, it is scope exists in both function disk 1 as well as disk 2. Whereas variable a is local variable and it lies within function or a scope disk 1, so it is not accessible to any other function. To make the program work properly, remove the first statement of the method disk 2. So like this, you know that we can identify or we can create our program. Thank you. I'll come with something more in the next class with next video. Till then, bye.